Every story begins at the end of another. I can't.
Zuberi? Zuberi.
Mama, I miss him, Ma. I miss him so much.
I know. I miss him too. Maybe if you go to see him, pay your respects?
No, I can't. I can't do that yet.
Zuberi.
Mama, I can't.
Your Baba, he left this for you, for the days after. When Baba found out he was sick, the look on his face, the anxiety, the fear, the anger, even a little confusion. But he had this sudden drive to write. He started this book. I think he wanted to make sure he had a good story to tell his son.
What's it about?
I don't know. But maybe it is for you to find out. Take your time, Zuberi.
My story began at the end of a world I once knew. The shaman's path is one of healing, one of guiding. Yet, how does a shaman perform his duties when he is the one in need of healing? Of guiding? Baba. Help me, Baba. I need you, Baba. Kalunga, God of Death, hear my plea. Kalunga, God of Death, come to me. Kalunga. Thank you. Kalunga, god of death, guardian of the veil between the realm of the living and the dead. My name is Zhao, shaman of Amandla.
And why, Zhao, shaman of Amandla, have you called me to the realm of the living?
It is told that there are three great spirits who have denied you. And if a shaman can cross your veil, having shepherded these spirits with death in tow...
Great favor by death, true wealth bestowed. I know the tale. And tell me, Kijana, what wealth is it that you seek?
My Baba, a sickness plagued him. You have taken his soul, and I am here to reclaim it back. I seek my Baba's return in exchange for these spirits.
But those who fail...
Kalunga's grace shall know. I know what is at stake.
What do you, truly? All I see before me is a boy. A desperate boy with a desperate plea.
I am a shaman. My father's son, wielding his masks, knowing his ways. I can do this, Kalunga. I know I can.
Words carry little weight against the strength of action. But you have spirit. This much is true. We go east. Perhaps there you may prove to me you are worthy of such a task.
I will show you my worthiness. Show you the grace of the moon.
You look at these statues with anguish, Nganga. What ails you?
When I was young, my Babi would admire these statues with fear. And every time we passed through these crossroads, I would look at them and...
Now you look at them and are reminded of the reality and challenge that befalls you.
No.
I don't say this to mock you, Zhao, but this is not Easterly.
I know what I am doing.
A shaman gate. We may be missing something to pass through it. powerful mask.
I use the mask to channel my power. It is the mask of the moon. Baba taught me the way. We should keep moving.
I am fine. A gazelle that limps will struggle to outrun the lion.
Maybe you are right. I've seen many spirits, but never so unsettled.
You now walk with the presence of death by your side, and these spirits linger here, not ready to let go. You do them a service by performing your duties and giving them peace, Nganga.
Sealed gate. No matter. There must be a key nearby. I will show you the strength of the sun.
A powerful history.
The mask of the sun. Baba showed me that to wield it is to harness a most ferocious love.
Your Baba taught you.
Not just a boy now, eh?
Only time will tell.
The sun. The moon. I must embrace the dance.
It is the spiritual property that resides through your resonance as a shaman. It can accentuate your... When the time is right, use this energy through Ulaji Zao. You can become stronger.
I cannot reach it.
Fury, Shaman. Fury and grace.
The mask of the sun and the moon. Baba would say the sun and moon never oppose one another, never hold one over the other. It is a balance. Come on. Floating Griot idol. Do you feel that too? That energy?
I do. It is not a sense of apprehension or fear, only
inspiration. It is calming. I want to go closer, but I am not sure.
Approach it, Zhao. Awaken its energy.
The boy stood before a being he was familiar with, yet a stranger too. Finally, now to the gate.
Zhao, I have seen enough. I will journey with you, Shaman. This is the road to Ikakaramba.
The sooner I bring you the Great Spirit, the sooner you return my Baba to me, yes?
This will not be easy, Shaman. Those before you have tried.
Then I will not. Come, we're making little progress standing around. Get to Ikakaramba.
A lilting voice. Give her a moment. Let her finish her melody.
I cannot wait. Hey, move, please.
Huh?
I said move. So, wait. Another obstruction! The gates, the spirits, the girl, now this stupid bridge!
I was not expecting that.
What?
A shaman to be bested by a bridge.
It did not best me!
It did. You are careless. Since we began, you have been so focused on reclaiming what you feel is yours that you disregard yourself, others, the very journey itself.
What? That is not true! I am doing this for my Baba.
Recklessly charging with abandon, scaring a little girl, endangering her life and yours? You do this for your Baba? You wish to walk this path? Do it with respect.
That girl up by the bridge, she was calling to something in the sky. She may know of the Great Spirit we are seeking.
Perhaps. steps. But first, you must find a way to the surface. This symbol. Greatness. Greatness. Fools chase it, yet heroes are found by it. What is such a symbol doing here?
I once saw my Baba paint the same symbol. It must be a way of the shaman, a challenge of some sort.
Not every challenge needs a challenger. Let us continue our journey. We have much to do.
No, you do not understand. Beyond there is a power. I can feel it, one that only we can use. All I have to do is get through it, prove my worthiness as a shaman.
The choice as always is yours. If you believe you can, then you must, but be cautious.
I've seen this before. A shaman's trinket. See how delicate it is. Powerful, too.
Yes. You are lucky, Zhao. This power in the wrong hands would be disastrous. Today, it has found a hopeful host. You are a shaman of Kinzera. Use this power how the others would have wanted. For good. For greatness.
First weeks of the sickness, Zhao had never left his Baba's side. It would best me.
Yes, I did.
Shows how much faith you have in me.
Yes, it does. affected by their lingering circumstance. They have abandoned their jesting nature for spite. Do not underestimate them, Zhao. Jumbos, pay them no caution. They do not seek to offend or harm. Truly, they are good people. Their only wish is to care. They rejuvenate and welcome others. They help. Come, take a moment. A traveler must rest to know the ground has shifted.